This is the Strat-O-Matic Baseball Excel 1970-73 Carryover League. Brought to you by the Shrimp Trawler YouTube channel.
Welcome back, baseball fans, to the Summer 70-73 Carryover League in the American League West tonight with a fine divisional series between the Texas Rangers and Oakland A's. We'll just go right into this best of seven series, show you what's happened. It opens up in Texas, Game 1, Catfish Hunter versus Mike Paul. And the A's get a two-run homer in the first by Tennis, another homer by Mike Hegan in the eighth, and Catfish Hunter sails along with a four-hit shutout. It is 5-0 final for the Oakland A's on the road. At this point, Oakland is undefeated on the road. They won 3 games in Minnesota, lost 2 games in Oakland. So they are undefeated on the road at this point. Game 2 in Texas, and that streak comes to an end. It is Pete Broberg against Ken Holtzman, who's really struggled this year. He struggled against the Twins, struggling again today. In the first, Frank Howard, 2-run bomb. Mike Epstein, 2-run bomb. In the third, Merv Rettman, 2-run bomb. Mike Epstein, solo bomb. You get the idea, folks. Holtzman's transition into Oakland's 3 spot behind Vita Blue and Catfish Hunter is not going over very well early on. And 8-3 will be the final in this game. So, the Rangers get the split at home, and they go to Oakland. Will the Oakland A's win a game at home? They haven't done it yet. Game 3, a very tight game and a very pivotal game. Bill Hands against Cal Kuntz, the number 4 starter for Oakland. He had to be acquired in the Mike Hegan, George Scott, Marty Patton trade between Milwaukee, Oakland, and Boston in the offseason. Again, he's the 4th starter on the A's. He's like the Maytag repairman because Blue, Holtzman, and Hunter will do most of the damage for the A's this year. But Cal Kuntz does fine. He goes 6 innings, gives up 3 runs, a solo homer by Rettman, a 2-run job by that guy, Frank Howard. But the A's cobble together some offense here. Single runs in 4 different innings, and they win it 5-4. The Rangers cannot come back in this, and Raleigh Fingers gets a save. This is the one that the Rangers let get away. They had a chance here to go up 2-1 in the series, and they didn't, and they realized how bad that would be because Game 4 is Vita Blue time. Game 4, Vita Blue pitched twice in the opening series, which is why you're not only seeing him now in Game 4. And Vita Blue, yes. 6-1 final. The Rangers got a run in the 9th on a ground ball double play, as they didn't bring the infield up, figuring that you just want to get the game over with. Big game Bob Johnson lost to Vita Blue, who's looking like the AL Cy Young guy. Early on, Don Sutton, the National League, Vita Blue, and the American League are just mystifying batters. And the A's take a 3-1 series lead over the Rangers, who are starting to see the writing on the wall. They're a spunky crew, this Ranger club, but they just don't have enough horses. They're the young and the restless. They got the old crew, Frank Howard and Merv Rettman. They got the young crew in here, Jeff Burrows, Toby Hara. But they still have a bunch of holes all around those guys, pitching and offense and defense. And you just can't keep up with the Dynasty A's. And we're back to the Game 1 starters here in Oakland in Game 5. The A's want to finish them off. For Texas, it's Mike Paul, lefty starter 7. Nice card for him, acquired from the Indians. And for Oakland, it'll be Catfish Hunter, who threw a shutout in Game 1. Let's get started from the Oakland Alameda Coliseum. Merv Rettman will lead it off for the Rangers. Both teams have juggled their lineups because the first time these two teams met with this pitching matchup, it was a low-scoring game. So they juggled their lineups trying to get some more offense. Let's see if it works for one of the teams. Merv Rettman, 2-9 is a K. Billy Conigliaro rolls to second. Billy Conigliaro was one of the really nice... Let's take a look at his card. Really nice card for a guy who was only going to play against lefties. And he was starting to complain about it because he feels he's better than Ed Stroud. And so he's getting some more starts. This is a 18 home run and 400 at-bat player with 271... The 271 batting average for Boston. Nice acquisition for the Rangers. And he's getting more playing time, but he grounds out in the first. Okay, Mike Epstein, 55, grounds a second. All right, Angel Mangual, promoted to the leadoff spot against lefties. 1-8, grounds a third. Bert Campanaris, 5-10, catcher's card. This is Satriano, a 3-8 catcher. Two outs. And Joe Rudy will bat third against lefties now. 210, grounds are short. All right, top of the second. It's Frank Howard. 47's a K. Jeff Burrows, 59, rolls the second. Tom Satriano, 45, skies the center. So far, the new lineups haven't done anything. Reggie Jackson batting fourth. 1-7 against the lefty. Homer 1-2, fly ball, and that's a tease there. It's a fly ball. Gene Tennis, 2-8 is a K. Mike Hegan, 69, rolls to second. 0 for 12. Dave Nelson, 68, is a K. Toby Hara, 2-5, pops the third. Bernie Allen, 2-5, pops second. Bottom of the third inning, Sal Bando, 45. And we have a hit today, folks. 4-5 off Mike Paul, is double 1-14. That is a single for Sal Bando. Green, comma Dick, 67 is a K. Stan Swanson, 2-7, is a 6-4-3 double play. Well, top of the fourth. Merv Rettman, 4-4 off Catfish, bounces to short. This is Campanaris makes the play. Billy Conigliaro, 5-11, is a strikeout. And with two outs, it's Mike Epstein. 35 is a walk. We got a base runner. Look out, folks. Frank Howard, 52, skies the center field. Angel Mangual, 37, single, 1-19. And he rolls a 20, folks. My goodness, single 1-19 and a 20 is rolled for Angel Mangual. He can't believe it. What a diving stop that was by Toby Hara. Bert Campanaris, 210 as a K. And with two outs, it's Joe Rudy. 212, lines the second. One batter over the minimum as we go to the fifth. Jeff Burrows, 65 off of Catfish Hunter. Found his column. Not much in the column. It's triple one fly ball. He rolls a 2. Oh, boy. We are getting some crazy fun rolls today. But that will not drop in. Tom Satriano, 55, second C. And Dave Nelson, 38, is a walk. A stealer. You got to try a stolen base here. He's in there. So, runner in scoring position. Toby Hara trying to break up the no-no in the fifth. 49 is a pop to second base. Let's pause a moment for station identification.
This is the Shrimp Trawler video channel.
Este es el canal de videos de camaroneros.
Bottom of the fifth, scoreless in the Coliseum. Reggie, 33. Rounds the first. Gene Tennis, 4-11. Left X, this is Burrows, not very good, 48 in left field. That is a two-base error. And the A's have a man in scoring position. for Mike Hegan. 111, first B. We have a runner on the third with two outs for Bando. Oh, Bando, Sal Bando, 110 is a K. We have one hit combined. We have a one-hitter through 10 frames. into the sixth, we go with Bernie Allen. 2-6 is a line out the first. Merv Rettman, 3-10 is a fly ball left. Billy Conigliaro, 1-8. We saw the card earlier. You know what's there? It's gone. A home run for Billy Conigliaro, and it is 1-0 Rangers. There goes your no-no and shutout. Mike Epstein, 66, double 1-4, base hit. And with two outs, Frank Howard, 66, double 1-12, off of the Hunter card. He rolls a 10, it is a double. Epstein does not have the legs to score from first on the double though. And Hunter has come unglued here in the sixth inning. A homer, a single, and a double, all with two outs. And it's Jeff Burrows. 5-12, rolls the first. Well, it's up to the A's to score a run for their catfish. Dick Green leading off in the sixth. 38 is a K. Stan Swanson, 2-7, short. Angel Mangual, 37, single 1-19. Can we get one of these? Yes, this time it is the single. Let's look at the Mangual card. Originally, he was just going to platoon as he crushes lefties, as you can see, in center field. But he's really kind of won the team over as the full-time center fielder because he's got good defense, a 3-4 minus one arm. They do have another lefty you can play center, Von Joshua, though. He only hits around 265, so it's not a big deal. Mangual has a 15 runner, not a good base stealer, good base runner. And it's Burt Campanaris. 3-11, skies the left field. We go to the seventh. Tom Satriano for the Rangers. 66 off of Catfish. Double 1-4 is a single. Let's see, want to do anything fun with this guy? Let's get Satriano out of here. Let's get Ed Stroud on the bases. How about that? Yeah, let's get Ed Stroud, an A Steeler, on the bases here. Have some, get something going here in a 1-0 game. Dave Nelson's a B hit and runner. It's Catfish Hunter. Let's hit and run with Dave Nelson. 7, runner has to steal. Runner steals a safe on a 3, and that's a T rating. And what's the T rating of Gene Tennis? It's T 1-4, and he rolls a 3, and he ends up with third base. So, wow. That is a stolen base, and a ball goes into center field, and the runner ends up at third, and Dave Nelson is still batting. The infield is up. Actually, we'll move the stolen base to Ed Stroud's number. Dave Nelson, 48, is a pop to third. Let me put the stolen base next to Mr. Stroud. There you go. So it's Toby Harrow with the infield up. He's an A bunter. I never squeeze with just a runner at third. But we're going to do it. Toby Harrow's going to squeeze. And that's disaster. I rolled a 12. Okay, got a little over the skis. I haven't done a squeeze play in a long time. And that's probably why I haven't done a squeeze play in a long time. It was the Rangers, and Toby Harrow's a rookie, and bad things just happened there. Okay, so he misses the ball, and or it's a double play. What is a 12 again if you're a B? It's a max. You roll 12, it's maximum number of outs possible. Okay, that's what I thought. All right, it stays one zip. We got to put Ed Stroud in the outfield. We need a catcher, so Billings will come in for Epstein, and there you go. Now you've got everybody where you want. Mike Paul, 1-0, bottom of the seventh. It's Joe Rudy. 3-10, flies to left. Reggie, 1-4, hit by the pitch. Oh, he glares at Mike Paul on the mound, but dude, he's throwing a two-hitter. I don't think he was trying to hit you. So he strolls over to first base. Reggie's an A-bunter, but the new catcher, Billings, is a minus one arm. He's not going anywhere, particularly because Gene Tennis walks 100,000 times. Gene Tennis, 2-4 is a K, and with two outs and Mike Hegan up, Reggie's taken off. 13, this is close, folks. 15, 13, 1 to 12. He is out by a whisker. Can't believe it. Thought he beat the tag. He does not. It's a 1-0 game into the eighth inning. Bernie Allen leads it off. 49, center. Merv Rettman, 112, short. Canigliaro, the only offense today. 36, single on a one, line of short. And he missed that one. The only Ranger on the bench is Elliot Maddox. He doesn't play defense very well. He'll stay there. Mike Paul. He's your story, folks. He has a two-hitter against the Dynasty A's in a potential elimination game here. Down 3-1, trying to get the series back to Arlington. Mike Paul. Let me go over his stats again for you. 8-9 with a 2.17 ERA for the Rangers in 162 innings. That's a nice year. One loss record. Well, that's typical for the Rangers, but he pitched well. And if he loses today, it would fall in line with what he did. So, it'll be Hegan, the lefty, leads off. They got Paul Lindblad and Frank Lindsay warming in the bullpen. If you're wondering about the future or former Oakland A's on the Ranger roster, Mike Epstein is there and Paul Lindblad's there. And you don't think the A's are a little ticked that they can't have their own guys. But anyway, here's Mike Hegan. 49 off Paul is a walk. Good base runner, a 14 runner. Now you've got 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6 righties in a row. Dude's throwing a shutout. Let me take a look at Lindsay and... Oh, Lindsay's really good too. And Paul Lindblad. They got a good bullpen. Nah, you gotta break him to get him out of there. You gotta let the kid see what he can do. Make a star turn here. It'll be Bando. 111 for Bando is a 6-4-3 double play. Wow. And with two outs, it's Dick Green. 2-5, grounds to short. Mike Paul stands up to the big bad Oakland A's with 8 shutout innings. We go to the ninth. Catfish Hunter is a starter 8. He can go 9, but he can't go 10. It'll be Dick Billings leading off. 4-4, short X. Campanaris a 3. Makes the play. Wrong spot there. Frank Howard. 1-7, homer, 1-11. It is gone. Let's take a look at Frank Howard's card, 1970. This is where I was saying the Rangers are trying to do two things at once. They're bringing the old guard, the old Washington Senators, and the young Texas Rangers are combining, and they're trying to do something this year. And 1-7, homer 1-11 is gone. It's 2-0. Jeff Burrows, 68, is a K. And with two outs, Ed Stroud. Ed Stroud in for Satriano. 33 pops to second. 2 solo homers off of Catfish Hunter. Known to give him up. And it is Mike Paul taking a 2-0 lead into the bottom of the ninth inning in Oakland to force a game 6 back in Texas. Well, we forgot to do the stretch time music, but we are enjoying, of course, Inspiration Information by Shuggy Otis. I forget when this came out, but yeah. Great 2 CD set, often played here on the Carryover League Network. Yeah, we love our Shuggy Otis. In Oakland, in the bottom of the ninth, it is 2-0, Mike Paul. It'll be Stan Swanson on top of the lineup, Miguel Campanaris. Doesn't get any easier, gets a lot worse after that. But he's got a 2-run cushion. This kid can't lose. He puts a couple guys on, he gets hooked. Because we have more experience in Lindblad, a better lefty anyway, and Lindsay. So a couple guys is all it'll take to get Paul out of there. Stan Swanson leads off for the A's. 2-5, pops the first. Back to the top with Angel Mangual. 62 is a K, and with two outs in the ninth inning, it's Burt Campanaris. 1-4 is a bouncer to short, and it's Mike Paul. And they're jumping all over him. I mean, it's just a regular season game, but it feels like a World Series. Mike Paul shuts out the Oakland A's 2-0. Break up the Texas Rangers, down 3-1 in this series. They weren't giving in. The American League West is going to be a tough division this year. My goodness, folks. So Catfish Hunter loses. 5 hits, 2 solo homers, 2 walks, 5 strikeouts, another complete game. Hunter and Blue have pitched every inning of their starts. The bullpens have been quiet in all their games. Mike Paul gets that win. 2 hits, shutout, 2 walks, 7 strikeouts, a complete game. 1-009-0109-2502-2527. We'll look at the year-to-date numbers for the two squads. Vita Blue would come back on 3 days rest for Game 7, along with Bob Johnson if it goes to 7. But it's up to Kenny Holtzman and Pete Broberg in Game 6. Holtzman's been terrible this year, so Texas is encouraged. But let's look at the numbers now, starting with the A's. A's are 6-4, but they're at 277 with a 344 team ERA. That's very good. Haven't seen a lot of power yet. Can't figure out who their top hitter is at this point. It might be Mike Hegan, just kind of a surprise. Yeah, Vita Blue is 3-0, 5 runs in 26 innings. Catfish Hunter, 3 runs in 25 innings. You just saw 2 of them as solo home runs. Unreal. They have 4 complete games in their 6 starts. Yeah. And the Texas Rangers, they are 5-5, folks. They're only hitting 226 with a 331 ERA. They are getting the long ball. It is Mike Epstein with 5 homer and 12 RBI. And the big guy, Frank Howard, is just 3 homers and 6 RBI. You saw one of those. But we have played 116 games at this point of the year. The pitching's been outstanding. 261 league batting average, 376 ERA in the carryover league. We'll put results of the series at the end of the video. Thanks for tuning in. We'll see you next time. Okay, baseball fans, we are back to live action. We have to show you first what happened in game number 6 in Arlington, Texas. It's Ken Holtzman having a bad year against Pete Broberg. And once again, second inning for Holtzman, solo homer Rettman. 2 more runs in the 3rd, a run in the 5th. Solo homer Frank Howard in the 6th. Getting silly and stupid, 7-0. Haven't seen the A's score in a couple games now. It is a 5-hit shutout after Mike Paul's shutout. 18 shutout innings for Oakland. 7-0 final to force a Game 7. And that's where we were picking up in Game 7. Let's show you what's happening. First inning, Jeff Burrows off of Vita Blue. 2-run homer. This stadium is sold out. They have standing room only. Vita Blue in a Game 7. They get a 2-run homer by Burrows. The stadium goes absolutely crazy. But in the 3rd inning, Oakland finally scores some runs. A triple into the gap by French, and it's 2-2. But in the 6th inning, the great Vita Blue folds up to the pressure here. A single by Rettman, a single by Epstein. A walk to Billy Conigliaro. Bases loaded, 1 out, infield up. A bases loaded walk to Dick Billings? What is going on? A single by Elliot Maddox, and then another walk to Nelson, a walk to Burrows, another single, and Blue is out of there. Knocked out in the 6th inning. Vita Blue, the MVP of 1971. And the Rangers are leading this game 7-2 in the 9th inning. And that's where we pick this up. It is Big Game Bob Johnson. Got that nickname 3 years ago when he was the ace of the Royals. And was traded to the Rangers. Bob Johnson. Yeah. In 1970 for Kansas City, he was 8-13 in 214 innings, 3.07 ERA. Apparently, the Royals had too many right-handed pitchers. They had Mike Hedlund and Roger Nelson, so that's why they dealt him. But they love him here in Texas. 7-2. The only two runs was that goofy triple in the third on the defense. So here we are in the ninth inning, a five-run lead for the Texas Rangers, about to come back from a 3-1 deficit against the Big Bad Dynasty A's. Joe Rudy leads off in the ninth. 49 off. Johnson's a strikeout. Von Joshua. 37's a strikeout. Oh, with two outs, it's Bert Campanaris. 1-5. Let's take a look at Campanaris' card, though. Bert Campanaris with a solo homer here in the ninth. He had 22 of those in 1970. Yet another reminder that a lot of these Dynasty A players were actually better before the dynasty started. They were kind of into their late prime. But one of the advantages for those A's was that the Orioles were getting weaker and the Twins were getting weaker and so forth and so on. So 7-3 now with two outs. John Donaldson, 4-12, skies to left field. There it is, folks. Your Texas Rangers are in first place in the American League West. And the big bad Oakland A's are sitting at 500. Wow. A shocker. We'll do the box and the cumulative look in the standings here. Bob Johnson gets the win. 6 hits and 3 runs, all earned. 2 walks, 13 strikeouts in a complete game. Raleigh Fingers had to come on in the 8th inning for a garbage time inning. Bob Locker pitched an inning in the third. Gave up 2 hits. Vida Blue, though, blew up finally in his 4th start of the year. Gave up 6 hits. Gave up 7 runs. They were all earned. A stunning 8 walks and 7 strikeouts. Rangers take no guff off these A's. 1-009, 0-108, 7-9-3-6. 213-87 in a game 7. One of the best 7-game regular season series in a while. The Oakland A's scored 2 runs in 3 games there at the end. Kind of embarrassing when you think about it. Losing to Mike Paul, Pete Broberg, and Bob Johnson. The whole American League is now wide open, folks. Anybody in the American League can get to the World Series. Baltimore, Boston, the Yankees, Detroit, dare I say Cleveland, Kansas City, Minnesota, the White Sox, Texas, Oakland, and maybe California. It's wide open now that the Dynasty A's are just playing lackluster baseball, folks. Uninspired baseball. Kenny Holston's been getting lit up. He's been a terrible acquisition. The Rangers are 7-5, hitting .244, the ERA of 3. Bob Johnson in 31 innings has 38 strikeouts. Merv Rettman is 25 for 47, folks. If you're wondering what that is, it's a .532 batting average. So Merv's hitting .532 in 47 plate appearances. That's like a Rudy Pemberton stat. Might want to Google that if you get a chance. And let's look at the A's, who are 6-6, hitting .261 with a .411 ERA. Reggie Jackson this year is 2 homers and 7 RBI. Vida Blue is now 3-1. Catfish is 2-1. Holtzman, 18 innings, 19 earned runs. Not looking good. And when you look at the standings out west, the Rangers are 7-5. Mariners are 3-2, a half game back. A's 6-6, and this is all upside down now. The Angels lost their series, and the Mariners haven't played yet. So, but in any event, break up the Texas Rangers. Don't know how long this little giddy streak will last. But earlier on, they have impressed everybody in the American League. Thanks for checking out the video. We'll see you next time.